Hi, my name is Dr. Nicole Cutts, and I'm making this video to present two simple cognitive exercises that you can use to relieve stress in these turbulent times. Now, the first exercise is based off of the Serenity Prayer. If you're not familiar with the Serenity Prayer, it's on the right side of the screen, and it says, "Grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things that I can, and the wisdom to know the difference." So the first thing you do is you say the prayer through one time. That should bring you some sense of peace. But then you need to get more specific and actually look at what are those things you cannot change so that you can seek to accept them. And then what are the things you can change, and you're praying for the courage to do those things and to take action. So you'll write down what it is that you cannot change. And you would say something along the lines of what I have written here. If you want to use a higher power's name, that's fine. If you just want to say, "Grant me the serenity." So in my example, "Goddess, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change." And then you actually put in what those things are. Write them down, say them aloud. So for example, the racist thoughts or behaviors of others, the existence of the coronavirus, and then other people, and actually say those people's names, okay? You have to understand that you cannot change other people. So it helps to get into action around this to actually say, "I cannot change this person." But you're praying for the serenity to accept them. The next thing you want to do is focus on the things that you can change. So you would write down or say the things that you can change, and you're asking for the courage to actually do those things. So for example, the courage to change the things that I can, such as my attitudes and actions. And examples I give here: creating change in my community or organization, voting, helping another person, contributing money to a cause related to whatever this thing is that's disturbing me. Now, the thinking behind this is because oftentimes we're stressed when we're trying to change things that we can't, or when we're just overwhelmed by all the things we can't change. So this exercise helps you to separate the things you cannot change from the things that you can change. And then by getting into action around the things that you can change, you regain a sense of control, which would also contribute to lowering your stress. Lastly, you just continue to pray to know the difference between what you can and cannot do. And you continue to put things in those boxes. Now, this is an exercise that can be done over and over. I like to use it every day, and you can use it anytime you're particularly disturbed or anytime that you like. Now, the second exercise is what I call the 3 and 5 list. This is a modification of another exercise that I have, but in this case, it's used specifically to help you to relieve stress in these turbulent times. So what you want to do is 3 good things every day. Okay, so that's the 3. So the first thing, it doesn't have to be in this particular order, you want to make sure on a daily basis that you are doing 1 good thing for yourself. So for example, a self-care activity, exercising, eating healthily, spending time with friends, having some fun, pampering yourself. All of those things have to do with self-care. Getting rest, okay? You have to pace yourself. The second thing is 1 thing that's actually aimed at changing the thing that is causing you the stress or anxiety. So this goes back to in the Serenity Prayer, when you think about, okay, the courage to change the things that I can, make sure that you are doing 1 thing on a daily basis that actually helps to bring change to the situation. Again, we feel very hopeless and despondent when we just decide, "Oh, there's nothing I can do about this situation." It puts you in the position of being a victim, which is only going to produce stress, anxiety, sadness, okay? So there are things you can do. So if you, on a daily basis, take care of yourself, do that 1 thing that you can, doesn't have to be more than 1 thing, even something small is going to make a big difference. And then third, you want to also make sure that you're continuing to engage in 1 activity that supports your vision of success for your life or for your mission or your purpose, okay? So, for example, going to work, okay? That is something that you need to do every day for yourself. It helps to support you, maybe supports your family. Maybe you have a particular vision of success that you're working on that you need to be engaged with on a regular basis. So those are the 3 things. 1 good thing for yourself in the self-care arena, one thing aimed at changing the situation that's causing you stress and anxiety, and doing one thing that supports your vision of success or your life's mission or purpose. Then the five things, you write down five things for which you are grateful, okay? You can never have enough gratitude in your life. And what that helps you to do is exercise those synapses in your brain that will help you to feel happiness and pleasure, okay? So it also helps you to put your focus on what is good in your life versus the things that are causing you stress and anxiety. We do have a tendency to ruminate on things that are causing us stress. So this is a way to continue to focus. And again, you want to practice this on a daily basis because it really helps to exercise those synapses and the chemicals that create positive sensations in your brain on a daily basis and will help to relieve stress. Okay, so those are the two exercises. And lastly, you just need to think about what are you doing to take care of yourself, okay? One of the things that we know is that stress and anxiety have a very deleterious effect on our bodies, okay? Stress is a physical reaction to things that are going on in our environment because of the way that we think about them. So it is important that you do something on a daily basis to take care of yourself. Now, you don't have to go to the spa and meditate like this lucky little Jack Russell, but exercising, eating right, again, spending time with friends, going outside, taking a walk, all of those things are things that you can do to take care of yourself, and you want to make sure that you continue to do that. So I hope you found this helpful, and if you want to get more tips or ideas, you can always visit me on my website, which is cutsconsulting.com, or my other website, which is Vision Quest Retreats. And feel free to leave a comment and subscribe to my channel, and please share this with anybody that you feel that it would be helpful to.